Okay, I'm
Sorry.
muted. Welcome back. We have Martin Ortiz, our second presenter for today. So Martin Ortiz is a geographer from Buenos Aires, Argentina. He is currently taking a master's degree in statistics and learning computer vision. Like most of us, he likes maps, GIS, data, and FOSS. He mainly uses QGIS and R programs. So yeah, Martin, on to you.
Hi, I don't know if I can hear you right now.
Hi, Martin, you can start Hi. Your presentation.
Okay, yeah. Super, thanks. Okay, hello everyone. I'm Martin Ortiz, and I'm from here, from Buenos Aires. I live almost my whole life here, and I'm gonna talk about cultural space in the city. So I'm gonna share my presentation. Wait a minute, the screen. Okay, so here we are. So the name of this work is Spatial Analysis of Cultural Activities in Buenos Aires City. I'm going to show an indicator that I made for the Culture Ministry of Buenos Aires City. And the goal of this was to improve the location where they plan their public activities. So here we are. So about me, well, I'm a geographer. I study in Buenos Aires. I'm studying a master's degree in statistics. And I work for the Ministry of Culture in an area that his name is Data Cultura, Data Culture, or something like that in English. It's the area that manage the statistics of the culture of the city, and there we make some maps, charts, dashboard, and that kind of stuff. And yes, and I like maps and other things. And there is a photo of me in the social gathering. So how I plan this presentation? We have a context data of the city from a global perspective to a local perspective, the work objectives, the methodology, some tools that I use, and the results of this job. So about the context, Buenos Aires is one of the main cultural cities in the world. I really don't like to talk about cultural cities because it sounds pretty colonialist, and we all know that all cities are cultural. So yeah, it's another kind of discussion, but what I want to say is that cultural and creative industries have a relevant role in Buenos Aires economy and in the city life. There is a wide cultural offer, and is one of the main attractions of the city per international tourists and also for local tourists. If we check some statistics of the World Cities Culture Forum, we can see that Buenos Aires is the fifth city in the world with more theaters. It's just behind Paris, New York, Seoul, Los Angeles, and then we come Buenos Aires. I made this map, this world map, just for context to visualize where are these important cities. And here in the bottom in the right, there is a little map of the Buenos Aires city, and we can see the concentration of these theaters. Then, if we still talk about the global statistics, we can see that also Buenos Aires has a lot of museums. We are the fifth city in the world, behind Paris, Moscow, Los Angeles, Seoul, London. And also we can see here another map of the city and the cluster of these museums. If we talk about bookshops, we are not in the top 10 ranking, but we are still in the 20 top ranking. We have 371 bookshops in the city, and we are the second city behind Madrid if we talk about cities with who talks Spanish as a mother language. So it's very relevant, the dotation of bookshops and another kind of cultural spaces. So now if we talk about the local, from a local scale, we can say that the city has more than 2,600 cultural spaces. We can see here in this map where are located. Libraries and stage spaces like theaters and music clubs are the most recurring space in the chart. In here we use a public database, and we have another kind of space like cinemas, record stores, art academies or training space, bar, exhibition space like galleries or museums, libraries, bookstore, etc. Only from these 2,600 spaces, only 10% are public space. The rest of this group are private spaces. So what we can say of this map is that half of the cultural infrastructure of the city is located in three comunas. I couldn't translate the meaning of comunas, but it's like a kind of cluster of many neighborhoods together. It's like an territorial unit that we use in the city. But we can say that one commune is like one or two or three neighborhoods. So I was saying that most of the cultural spaces are located in Comuna 1, Comuna 3, and Comuna 14. And we can see in this map that there are like a cluster in the Comuna 1 and Comuna in the northwest of Comuna 3 and Comuna 5. So the cultural offering is very consolidated in one part of the city, and then in the rest of the city there are a lot of spaces, but maybe there are like isolated spaces. So another example, if you have gone to the social gathering of this platform, you can see that most of the places that are in that game or platform are in the Comuna 1 or Comuna 2 of this map. So after this analysis of where are the cultural spaces located, we started to ask how is the access to culture in the city, which areas have less cultural infrastructure, and does proximity influence access to cultural offering? So from this question, we have this work objective. The main objective of this work was to construct an indicator that will show how access to culture is in the city. And from this, we want, or we wish that this indicator could improve the localization of cultural activities organized by the ministry. It's it's relevant to say that there are a lot of private cultural offering in the city, and the ministry plays another relevant role to organize activities, cultural activities for everyone, for free, or most of them for free. So we have like two big groups, the private offering and the public offering. So in other words, the location of cultural spaces and infrastructure depends on many factors, like urban factors, economic factors, etc. But however, the Ministry of Culture can organize cultural activities in outdoor spaces, in its own spacing, or by making agreements with the private sector. So these are the objectives of this work and of this indicator. So about the methodology that we use, we want to measure the average distance to the closest cultural space, considering what type of space it is. As I said, we have a database that has a lot of space, and it's organized by the kind of space that it is. Like, you have bars, theaters, museums, record stores, libraries, etc., etc. We consider in this indicator seven type of spaces. We consider theaters, museums, cinemas, libraries, cultural centers, art academies or training space. I really don't know the correct translate to English language, but something like this. And music clubs, places where bands play a lot. Yes. We chose this kind of spaces because there are the favorite spaces of the neighbor from the city. So they are the ones that has more demand. To make this measure, we have in one side, we have the points of these cultural spaces. And then we have, we use every street corner of the city. So we want to take the distance between every corner to every kind of space. It's like a point of interest analysis. After we have all these measures, we translate it into different territorial units like hexagons, neighborhoods, and comunas. So what data set we use? All the data set that we have used are available in the open data portal of the city. We use cultural spaces, cultural activities, street links of the city, neighborhoods, and comunas. And in the back end of this indicator, we use OpenStreetData. So all of these data sets are open for everyone. If there is a link there, if anybody is interested to see it. So which tools we use? We use two tools. First, we use QGIS to work with the geometries and to make some kind of geodata wrangling. We convert the street links to points, to street corners. And for that, we use a tool called line intersection and delete duplicate geometries. With this process, the result was a dataset with more than 18,000 of points. So we have all points of all the city. It's a big kind of sample. And after that, we saw that these street corners doesn't match with the boundaries of the neighborhoods. So we use another tool that his name is Snap Geometries to Layer, and it's very useful because if you have something that it's near a point but it doesn't match, it fits it. So I was really surprised about this because if not, I was going to do by myself. Then another tool that we use is open source routing machines. We use this tool because we know that QGIS have the matrix, the distance matrix, and it's a very useful tool. But for this work, we don't want to have measures on the fly. We want to have we want to consider the urban grid of the city, because the measure that we wanted to do are as we are walking on the street. Open source routing machine has many modes of mobility, like a car, by foot, and by bicycle, and we choose by walking. Yes, another tool that we use was a Docker to run a local instance of the open source routing machine, and then we use R on the programming side. We make the routing queries, iteration, data wrangling, and we improve the processing time. That was very useful because we have a lot of points and a lot of measures to do. So we have done some stuff with buffer to improve the time of operations. Some consideration about open routing machine: it supports car, bicycle, or foot. It's based on OpenStreetData. It's writing in C++, but you can use very easily in R. And using R, you can get travel time matrix, the tool that we use, shortest path, isochrones, and travel trees with multiple points. And another interesting thing is it's very easy of installing a server on Docker. I have no idea about Docker, but it was very useful. There is an online server, but you shouldn't use if you are going to make more than million of operation. I don't know if you want to run it to measure 2 or 3 points, it's okay, but then you have to run your own instance. So some results that we had: the average distance to the closest cultural space in the city is near 300 meters. The 80% of the corners of the city are within the 1500 meters to a cultural space. A resident of San Nicolás, a neighborhood of the city, has to walk an average distance of 205 meters, while a resident of Villa Riachuelo has to walk almost 5,000 meters, or a resident of Villa Soldati has to walk more than 2,500 meters on average to access a cultural center. But we have here these maps that shows the different distance to different kind of space. But these numbers don't tell us anything about the variety of cultural offerings or the frequency of such offering. Here in this slide, we have the indicator results that there is the average of all of these 7 kind of spaces. The indicator not only accounts for distance, but also for a variety of cultural offering. We measure how close is a ecosystem of spaces. So we can analyze if you are in this corner, okay, you have to walk in average, I don't know, X meters to have a interesting cultural offering. We can see that only a small part of the city has a variety of cultural offering at a distance less than 500 meters. There are, in the maps below, there are different territorial units to see these results. All of these intervals are have 500 meters, and the yellow goes from 0 to 500 and so on. Most parts are within 1,000 meters. With these results, what we want or what we wish to do is to choose to improve the decision or where should the ministry must plan their activities. We know that there are a lot of concentration in some parts of the city, and then we hope that with this indicator they could have an offering in the whole city. Also, we can see what kind of activities need each part of the city, and the last part is the next step of this work is to show this information on a dashboard to bridge the gap between the planning area and the statistical area, because always we have a lot of maps, but then there are a lot of people that they don't tend to use maps, so there is an important gap in what we done and what they done, what we do and what that and what they do. So that's all. Yes, and this is the last slide. Thanks. Gracias.
Thank you so much, Martin, for that presentation on cultural spatial analysis in Buenos Aires. So I think we only have one question in the chat. So yes. What question is, are data maintained and updated in the Buenos Aires Open Data Portal? And I think I can add that if it is, updated, how do you also plan to update your dashboard?
Yes, we are the area that they make these databases, the cultural spaces and the activities. So we are we have the responsibility to do this work, this job. I don't know. No, we are maybe a little bit late, but we are working on this. And yes, we have to improve this, but we have updated databases. Yeah, that's true. This is like an example of this indicator, what I do it every month in different scales, and yes, it's updated.
Yeah, so there's another question. OSRM uses different computation methods depending on the number of points you provide. Was this handled in your computation?
Yes. It was one of the problems that we had, because we use the distance matrix tool. I don't know how to say in English, but it's like you point like your source point, and then it calculates to the whole of points that you have in your data set. So it's a lot of operation, and to improve that, we have made like a kind of buff. We made a lot of iteration for loops in R, and we make some kind of buffer between every point, because we really don't want to calculate the distance to every point. We are just interested in the closest point. So we have made some kind of buffer in every point, analyzing the average distance of and some variables. I don't know if I was clear because, it was a little bit hard to explain, but I can share the code. It's in my GitHub and yes. But it was, I think that we have to use like 8 hours to do this. But if you don't improve this buffer, we have like 2 or 3 days processing.
Yeah, related to that, the last question actually is how people can contact you. So if you can share any contact information in the venueless chat, that would
yes,
be very helpful. Yeah, so yeah, we don't have any more questions, but do you have any more closing message?
No, I think that the most interesting part of the Phosphor is to contact people and to see how they work. So, of course, I'm going to share my mail and my social networks. I really want to thanks to the Geoinquietos Argentina and the members of Phosphor Sheet that they have to work a lot to do this meeting, but it's pretty cool. I think I'm very happy to be here.
Yes, yes. Thank you for being here as well, Martin. So okay. Thank you for watching, everyone. We'll be back in 2 minutes for our next presenter.